Welcome back. In this video, I will discuss F test for multiple regression. I assume you must be aware of F distribution and also have an idea of ANOVA. Let's start with the idea behind the F test. I have two regression models, a large one with multiple predictors, another with lesser number of predictors. We are fitting both the models, the large one and the small one, to the same dataset, and we have some errors in fitting. With increase in the number of predictors, the RSS drops. So the RSS of the small model would be bigger than that of the large model. In other words, the large model has better fitting. But following the principle of Occam's razor, we favor a simpler model over a complicated one. Then how should I decide whether I should choose a small model over the large one? To help myself, I define a measure. RSS of S, that is a small model, minus RSS of the large model divided by the RSS of the large model. This measure estimates how big is the error in the small model with respect to the error of the large model. If this measure is very big, we should reject the small model and go for the large one. I will use this idea of comparison between a small and a large model in the F test. Now back to the F test for multiple regression. We use this test to check the overall significance of our regression model. We are checking whether our multiple regression model with several predictors is significantly better than a model without any predictors. Like other hypothesis tests, we will have two models here, a null model and an alternative model. The generalized multiple regression model is y equal to alpha plus beta 1 x plus beta 2 x plus up to beta k xk. So we have k predictor x1 to xk. Our null hypothesis is that the coefficient of all the predictors from x1 to xk are 0. That means all these betas are 0. The alternate hypothesis is that at least one beta is not equal to 0. So our null hypothesis is the small model, as it does not have any predictors, right? And in fact, it is the smallest model. And the alternate model is the large model. To compare these two, the small one and the large one, in other words, the null model and the alternate model, I will use the RSS of these two models. I know the RSS of H1, the alternate model. It is the RSS that we had discussed earlier for regression models. It is equal to the summation of the squares of the deviations of yi hat from yi. But then what is the RSS of the null model? To understand that, let's check the equation of the null model. Our null model is y hat equal to alpha. No beta here. All betas are 0. I have to estimate alpha from the data. For that, we will use regression. In other words, I will minimize the RSS of the error in the model. For minimization, I differentiate the error with respect to alpha and then set that equal to 0. Now replace yi hat by alpha. Do the differentiation in steps. By rearranging the terms, I get alpha equal to summation of yi from I equal to 1 to n divided by n, that is equal to y bar, the mean of y. So our null model, the small model, is y hat is equal to y bar. So the RSS of this model would be summation of the square of yi minus y bar. So our measure to compare between the small model, the null model and the alternate model becomes summation of yi minus y bar square minus summation of yi minus yi hat square divided by the summation of the square of yi minus yi hat. Can you recognize this denominator? We know the relation between the deviations, right? ESS equal to RSS plus ESS. The denominator here is the ESS minus RSS, and that is equal to ESS of the multiple regression model. So what do I get? Our measure for how bad the null model is equal to the ESS of alternate model divided by the RSS of the alternate model. Understand this relation. We are doing regression with multiple predictors. That is our alternate model, H1. We know the RSS and ESS for this regression model. We can easily calculate that. So we will use this ESS and RSS of our regression model to measure how bad the null model is. If this measure is big, then our null model is bad and we reject that. Now, how big is big enough? For that, we need to take help of probability distribution. I'll skip the details, but we can show that ESS follow chi-square distribution with degrees of freedom k. And it is also known that RSS follows chi-square distribution with degrees of freedom n minus k minus 1. Here n is the number of data point, k is the number of predictors in your model, that is x1, x2 up to xk. Sigma square is the true variance of error, I mean the population level. Rather than taking the ratio of ESS and RSS, I will now scale them by their respective degrees of freedom and then take the ratio. So we get a ratio of two chi-squares scaled by their respective degrees of freedom. And we know that a ratio of two scaled chi-square have F distribution. ESS divided by its degree of freedom is called the mean sum of squares due to regression. It is written as MSR. RSS divided by its degree of freedom is called the mean sum of squares of error, or in short, MSE. So now we have MSR divided by MSE. This is called the F statistics or F value. Remember, this F value in a way measure how bad is our null model is. If this F statistics is bigger than a critical F value, we reject the null hypothesis. That means all betas are not zero. In other words, all the predictors are not insignificant. We have to consider the predictors in our model. So that means I have to check whether the F value that is coming from my regression model is bigger than the critical F value or not. So just like critical T value, I can get the critical F value from the table of F distribution. The critical value will depend upon the degrees of freedom of MSR and MSE, and also on the P value, the level of significance that you choose. Usually, the p-value is considered in biological experiment 0.01 or 0.05, something like that. But when you use a tool like R, the software reports the f-value itself and also reports the corresponding p-value following appropriate f-distribution. So we have to check only the p-value. That's all for this video. We have learned the f-test for multiple regression. Here, we are testing the overall significance of the predictors in explaining the dependent variable. The F value is the ratio of MSR and MSE. If the F value is greater than a critical F value, we reject the null hypothesis. And when we reject the null hypothesis, we mean and we accept that the predictors or the independent variables are important in explaining the dependent variable. Thank you. Happy learning.